Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Before we start, I'd just like to say thank you to every one of you, including the newbies that have subscribed, for supporting my channel, watching the videos. I really do appreciate all of you guys. And also I'd like to tell you that I'm doing personal readings now, so you can find the information in the description box down below. So this is a channel message for you. Gonna start with my cards here, the Star Clairvoyant, and then we move on to tarot and what, see whatever else I get drawn to, may not get drawn to anything. So don't forget, these are energies as well. And don't forget, take what resonates, throw out what doesn't resonate with you. So spirit, angels, ancestors, what channel message do you have for the collective today? What channel message do you have for me, lovely? So we have, karma is kicking my butt for what I put you through. Okay, interesting already. It was never about you, it was all about them. Hang on. Let's get a bit more. I need to know more about that. It was about them. Okay, let's get any more spirit. I fear your reaction if I reach out to you. Okay, so we'll pick those three cards there. On the back of the deck, the way you love me, no one can compare. Okay, well, so from this channel message that I'm getting here, guys, this person really royally effed up. So, so whatever they did to you, they're saying that karma is literally kicking their butt at the moment. So they might be experiencing the same thing that they put you through. And they really want to reach out to you, but they fear how you're going to react to them when they do this. And they're also saying that, you know, even if they have moved on, this message that's come through, and they've had other relationships, they do not compare to you. It's like I'm picking up that you're the one that got away, and there's huge regret here. But I really want to know about, it was never about you, it was all about them. So clarify that one, please, spirit. What is this? It was never about you, it was all about them. Tell me more about this. It was never about you, it was all about them. Thank you. So what I'm picking up here, guys, is two scenarios here is what I'm picking up is that they either, whoever this is, decided they wanted a new beginning. They wanted to take a chance with somebody else is what I'm picking up here. Now, you know, they may have seen this person as their soulmate. They may have had a mutual connection to them, you know, feel, you know, love at first sight is what I'm picking up here. And the other scenario that I'm picking up here is that they would like a new beginning with you because they do notice now that you are their soulmate. So like I said, take what resonates here. We have the Two of Pentacles on the back of the deck is all about juggling. And I see this at times as juggling two people. But tell me more here, spirit, about the Fool. That came out sideways. The Nine of Shields is Nine of Pentacles. It's being single. It's someone that is single, someone that is doing very well financially. You know, they're very independent. They're secure in themselves. They're loving life. But because it came out sideways, this person was not single. This person was not free. or is not free at the moment and is not loving life at the moment, I do feel like that this new beginning that they thought they were going to get, it didn't work out the way they thought it was going to work out. And, you know, maybe they are single now at the moment, but they're not loving life. They're not enjoying themselves. They're not enjoying their wealth because they've got no one to share it with, basically. Yeah, look, the moon Pisces energy here. It speaks about illusions, you know, lies, secrets, things not being, you know, revealed. Maybe you're still kept in the dark about what happened with this person. Maybe you didn't know. Maybe you had an inkling that... and my light's flashing again, so I usually take that as confirmation that, that what I'm saying is true. That you did, you know, maybe you had an inkling that they were with someone else or there was someone else. Tell me more about the Two of Cups. Queen of Cauldrons and the Nine of Swords. Yeah, look. This is why they regret it. This is really why they regret what they did to you. And no one compares to you. You know, you guys are the Queen of Cups here. Don't forget, these are energies as well, because we're all energies. So Queen of Cups is a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Now, they saw you as someone that was very loving and warm, you know, kind. You know, you were loyal, faithful. You know, you were all these kind of things. And you had this big cup of love to offer to them, you know, and you gave this to them and they took advantage of this. They didn't treat you well, is what I'm seeing. And now the regret is, you know, that they are in the Nine of Swords. Nine of Swords is someone that has a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of regrets, you know. They stay up thinking about it. It's like they haunt, it haunts them. It's like they, it haunts them in their dreams. It haunts them in their waking hours. And this is what, this is the energy that this energy is in at the moment, is the Nine of Swords, the huge regret for letting you go. Tell us more about this situation. More Queen of Wands. Tell me about the Queen of Wands. Yeah, thought as much. Yeah, there was someone else. There was someone else that they chose over you. And that's why they fear your, you know, how you're going to react if you were to reach out to them, because I do believe that this person thinks that, you know, would be a bit cheeky if they were to reach out to you. And what they want to tell you now is, you know, they made plans with this Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands is seen as the other woman or the other man in the tarot deck as well. So I'm seeing her as the other woman. I'm just going to say other woman because it's a woman card, okay? Now, there was a lot of sneaking around behind your back with this energy here. So there was a lot of phone calls, sneaky texts. This is what I'm picking up with the Queen of Wands here. Now, I'm just picking up lust. I'm picking up like it was just last full energy here, because we've got the devil, we've got the queen of wands, we've got the page of wands. It was like they were drawn in by sex is what I'm picking up. You know, the energy of the queen of wands is someone that is very beautiful, very attractive, very sexy. She uses her body to get what it is, what it is she wants. You know, she knows how to use her tools, you know, those tools to get what she wants. You know, she knows how to manipulate the situation or people. And this is exactly what she did. And this is what lured them in. So there was a lot of sneaky phone calls and a lot of back and forth between both of them. Now, what this energy didn't realize is that the Queen of Wands was very toxic. Like someone that they thought they were getting, it's turned very toxic. That's why I feel like they're in this energy here now. And I feel like they're not quite single yet. So just be very careful. If this person was to reach out to you, they're not single. It's not done yet is what I'm picking up here, because this card is like this. You know, up here it's single. Like this, they're not single. This is not done yet. The karmic is still around. And I feel like you would get dragged into this. So what I'm picking up here is that they ended up with someone that's basically lower vibration to them, lower vibration to you. We're looking at Capricorn energy here, fire sign as well, Aries, Gemini, Libra here, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, sorry. So yeah, you know, they ended up with someone that was very toxic. It's, like I said, like a sex addiction. It could have just been just sex fuel, you know, is what drew them together. But it's turned toxic. And this new beginning that they wanted, they thought they were going to get, like, you know, the family and the moving in together and starting a life together, love, you know, commitment. But they didn't get that, because the Ten of Cups sometimes is not guaranteed. And it's not guaranteed with the Queen of Wands. Wow, big mistake. Tell me more about the Queen of Wands and the Devil. You know, the Queen of Wands scene as well, like, I think what's happened is where she's become toxic, you know, with the Devil card here. It's turned out that what they thought they were getting is now the reality of what they've actually got is someone that is a bully, someone that could be very spiteful, very jealous and insecure, you know, very manipulative as well, and someone that is very unfaithful, you know. Then this is what I feel like they ended up with, and this is why karma, that card there that says karma, is kicking my butt for what I put you through. So like I said, it could be now that they're experiencing whatever it is that they put you through, they're actually experiencing it tenfold, you know, because they chose someone at a lower vibration to them. So we've got the Emperor here, Aries. So we've got a lot of air. We've got a lot of fire sign here. Tell me about the Father. No, I don't even know, need to know about the Father. Wanted to clarify the Queen of Wands and the Devil, okay? They're both working at a lower vibration to you. You guys are, you know, you're up there. These two are down here. They've got a lot of lessons to learn and a lot of karmic debt to pay off as well. And with the Emperor here, with her, with the Devil that's come out, it's both of them are really not good enough for each other, but in a way they sort of deserve each other, if you know what I mean. And with the Emperor here, this is someone who is weak-minded when it comes to the Queen of Wands, weak-minded when it comes to her manipulation and her games, basically her toxic ways. They're weak when it comes to her. And I do feel like it's because she uses her body to get, you know, what it is that she wants, you know, to put the emperor where she wants him. You know, the emperor is usually someone that's really strong, someone that takes control. But I do also feel like she's got very strong control tendencies. She's got a hold over this emperor and she doesn't want to let them go. 2 minutes, spirit. Tell me more about the father and the devil. This. Okay, the High Priestess, what I'm seeing here is the father here, the Emperor, actually is keeping hidden his feelings or her feelings. It's an energy here towards you here. Okay. The thing that they're keeping hidden here is we've got a couple here. Where is she? This is you two. Okay. This is you two right here. And what's being hidden from the Queen of Wands here, what they're not telling the Queen of Wands, is that they still have very strong feelings and a lot of love towards you, which we've already got in my cards up there. The channel messages up there. So basically, they're not revealing to the Queen of Wands how they feel about you, the love that they feel for you, how they wish they could be back with you as a couple, because like I said, this is a couple here. So it's like he's playing, the Emperor's playing a game at the moment with this Queen of Wands, you know, like telling her what she wants to hear, telling her, you know, to keep her happy. Because I do feel like she's not very stable, this Queen of Wands. I think also it's to protect you guys as well, so it doesn't end up on your doorstep. You know, and now they're acting like they've got this, you know, I'm a wounded warrior, I'm a wounded soldier, you know, things didn't go the way I wanted them to go. Now I'm feeling really lost and down, and my mental health is suffering at the moment because of what I did. I've screwed up, basically, is what I'm hearing. Tell us a bit more, spirit. What more? What more do we need to know? What more do we need to know, spirit? We have the Magician, Six of Wands, Queen of Pentacles, and the Four of Pentacles. So what I see here with the Father here, you know, and the King of Cups here, they're trying to manifest you back into their life. They're trying to find a way to be able to come back to you, you know. And they do have the skill to do this. They're trying to find a way to maybe manipulate the situation with the Queen of Wands, you know, to get rid of her or him. But I also picking up here that there's only so long that the Emperor can actually wear this mask with this Queen of Wands, you know, because at the moment they are all about wearing a mask, you know, putting on an act for the Queen of Wands, and this mask is starting to actually slip. Now they want to come towards you, you know, because they can't let go of you. They still really hold on to you, you know. They feel really, you know, gutted that they're not with you, so they still hold you quite close to their heart here. But then you've got the Queen of Wands here that is holding on to them, that's not wanting to let go of them, you know, because she's very possessive here. Now, the Emperor actually sees you guys as, you know, someone that is so valuable. They see yourself, you know, your worth now. They see how valuable you were to them. And like I said, there is a huge regret here that they didn't notice this when they were actually with you. They thought the grass was greener on the other side is what I'm seeing here. And they want to come back and they want to, you know, they would like victory with you. They would like to be able to get the outcome that they want with you. Tell us about the Magician. Yeah, look, they want to smooth things over with you, and I think that is why they fear your reaction. They want to reach out and talk to you. They want to be able to fix things with you. They want to be able to say, I'm sorry, but it's whether you forgive them or not. Yeah, look, Three of Pentacles here. I feel like they may be talking to someone that you know, maybe trying to find out whether it's safe to come and speak to you, is what I'm hearing. But I feel like they're talking to someone about this. Someone that you know, collective is what I'm picking up on. To test the waters, to see whether it's the right time to reach out to you. But like I said, be very wary, because then they're not done with the karmic at the moment. They're not done with the Queen of Wands. She's still lurking about there. So what advice do you have to the collective spirit? What advice do you have? Tell me about the Hangman. See what I'm seeing. The spirit's advice to you is like this. This is like a sticky situation. Basically, it's like you are playing the waiting game. I suppose maybe you guys are hoping that they're going to come back and fix things with you. You know. So things are at a standstill at the moment. Things are not moving at the moment. And we have Aquarius energy here as well. Yeah, spirit's advice to you guys is here that... don't waste your time, basically, is what spirit is saying here. You know, you can take it or you can leave it, but spirit is saying don't waste your time. You know, things are never going to change, basically, is what I'm seeing from the Hangman here. It's always going to stay the same. It's always going to be the same. It could be that you may not want to let go. It may feel like you feel like you're... I don't know why I'm getting, like, being pressured into this. It could be that even... some of your friends are actually trying to pressure you into, you know, communicating with this energy here, and you don't want to. Now, you've been through a lot of things, you know, you've been through a lot with this energy here, okay? And spirit is saying that you deserve to be happy, you deserve to follow your dreams, you've got a bright future ahead of you, and if you want it, it's yours with the star. Because spirit is saying, you know, it could be that this person may try and trap you, you know, and getting you pregnant or making you pregnant if you're male. But your mental health will suffer. You will feel trapped in your head about this situation, you know, like it could be that you were constantly worrying whether they're going to do it again, whether you can trust them or not, you know, and that's the energy that you could end up being in. Tell me about the Hangman. What more advice do you have, spirit, please? Yeah, look at this. Thanks, spirit. I love when spirit does that. So you've got forward movement here. Something is coming towards you, or someone is coming towards you. And it's happening quite fast. Now, this is a sneaky energy here. This is someone that lies. This is someone that steals, someone that cheats. tries to get away with something, tries to manipulate the situation. It's what spirit is saying here. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Oh, sun upside down. Wow. Eight of Swords again, guys. Spirit is saying your advice to you is, if this energy comes back to talk to you, which I do feel like they will do, they will reach out to try and communicate with you and maybe promise you all sorts of things. But what Spirit is saying here, the advice to you is that because this person is so sneaky, they're not going to be honest with you. And Spirit is saying that you will experience loneliness. You will experience instability in the relationship. Your relationship will be unstable, and this will is what's going to put you in the Eight of Swords mentality here, you know, the depression, feeling trapped, feeling like I can't get out of this, you know. I mean, Spirit is also saying, like I said, can you actually really trust this person? Tell me about the Sun in reverse. You know, this is what I'm seeing here with the Seven of Swords. Is going to come back and give you the line of, you know, all these promises, but they're empty promises. It's unstable. It's like that with the Hangman there. Ooh, fucking heck. Yeah, you're not. Yeah, I like this. Yeah, look. You've left this person out in the cold, and I feel like if they reach out to you, you are going to leave them out in the cold, or you're going to be very cold towards them when you do speak to them, because of how they put you in this, you know, in this situation here where they turned cold towards you. They left you at, you know, they left you behind. They didn't give you, they didn't care about you. They didn't care about your mental health. They didn't care about your state of mind at the time. You know, and you, I feel like you got quite sick when this happened as well. You know, maybe you wasn't eating, maybe you wasn't sleeping. You know, your overall energy was very, very low here. And you have become very cold towards this person. I feel like there isn't any love here anymore. I feel like it's just literally just iced over. Now, that clarifies that with the Queen of Swords here. Aries, Gemini, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius here as well. Air sign, Queen of Swords, she's been deeply hurt. She's been deeply, deeply hurt. Now, when you hurt the Queen of Swords, she's all about protecting herself. She can see through your crap from a mile away, and you're going to see through this Seven of Swords here. You're going to see through their BS when they come and communicate with you, because you've experienced it with them, and you're defensive. When it comes to them, you want to protect yourself, which is understandable, which I don't blame you. And I do feel like you are going to be very honest with this person, you know, because you're still carrying a lot of sadness and a lot of grief for what they did to you. You know, this is the Five of Coins as well. And they deeply wounded you here. You know, Five of Swords, you had to walk away. You had to accept that, you know, that they chose somebody else and left you behind, and you walked away. You know, there's I do feel like you walked away with self-respect. I don't feel like you really did much to cause a scene. So yeah, you're in the Queen of Swords defensive mode right now with this person. You don't trust them whatsoever. And that's what I like about the Queen of Swords. She's very intelligent when it comes to seeing through someone when they're lying. And that's you guys. And the reason why you're defensive is because you've got this new beginning here. You're on your own journey. You're moving on. You've already moved on by the looks of it. You know, you've either moved or it could be that you've bought a new home, it could be that you started a new job, or it's that you're traveling a lot at the moment, but you've got this beautiful, abundant future in front of you and you're embracing this, guys. So let me get some, where are they? Messages from the heart from this person. Let's see what else they want to tell you before I close the reading. So what else does this energy here want to say, spirit? Thank you. Plotting. They're stepping up their game to get your attention because they know you have plenty of other options. But you know what? Whatever. Arsehole. That literally goes with the Seven of Swords right here. Is they're up to no good. They're being sneaky about things. You know, trying to come back. And I feel like they are communicating with people that you know. So just be careful what you tell certain people. There's certain people that you don't really trust fully. Follow that gut instinct. But yeah, they're plotting. They're plotting at the moment to come forward. Because they know that you're moving on with your life. Or it could even be that you have actually already moved on with someone, you know. Tell us a bit more, please, spirit. Betrayal. Their fleeting heart will only end up betraying you in the end. Your soul deserves better. Thanks, spirit. I love it when you do this. What did I say in the tarot cards here? Is that they will do it again. They're not done. Spirit's advice to you was that you will literally be with the sun in reverse. Your relationship will be unstable. They don't have any morals, basically, to be faithful to one person. It's like they see a shiny new object and off they go. It's like a magpie, you know. And then we've got children. Children are affecting this connection. Be patient and allow them to resolve the things of the highest of the good. So it could be maybe some of you have children with this person. Maybe they've had children with the karmic here. But for some of you here with this card, is what I'm getting is if you've got children with this person, it could be that this is affecting their relationship with the karmic, with the Queen of Wands. They're not happy about this. But and I also said earlier that just to be careful when they try and come back, it could be that they might want to try and trap you, is what I saw as well somewhere. I can't remember. Ooh, just struck my ear. Beauty and grace. They find you extremely beautiful, but your beauty intimidates them. They think someone else is more deserving. Okay. So they find you very beautiful, but they also think someone else is more deserving than you are. Actually, no, sorry. They actually know that you deserve better with this card. So much better than them, and they know this, but they can't let you go. Choices. There is a choice they have to make. They know time is not on their side and risk losing you forever if they don't. Now, for some of you, if you want to take this energy back, they know they've got to make a choice by getting rid of the karmic, which is the Queen of Wands. But like I said, for some majority of you that's watching this, I don't feel like you do want to get back with them. Like I said earlier, that with the Nine of Coins going that way, they're not done with the karmic at the moment. They're still involved with this Queen of Wands. So I'm going to leave it there, guys. You take care and I'll see you soon. Bye.